Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome to your first impressions of the brand new early access game, Risk of Rain 2. Now, you might be wondering, I didn't even know that they made Risk of Rain 2. You'd be not in the minority on that, because I'm pretty sure no one knew that they were making a sequel to the very popular and very awesome Risk of Rain. This is made by the same developers, I do believe. I did not receive this copy of the game as part of a developer mail or anything like that. I actually just bought the game because as soon as I heard that it was coming out, I was like, it's out right now, excuse me. So I did go buy it for $19.99. You can get one copy, and if you buy it before the 30th, you actually get an additional copy for free. What is Risk of Rain? Risk of Rain, the first one anyway, is a roguelite side-scroller shooter where you basically just try to survive and get to the end of a level just to progress and beat bosses. There's tons of item synergies, and it gets insane. The game is well known for getting progressively harder the longer that you play. No matter what difficulty you're playing on, it's going to ramp up the pain. Risk of Rain 2 is a take on the first game, except you're literally playing it in the third person now. So for those of you who know anything about Risk of Rain 1, you know that the game can just get bonkers. We're talking thousands of enemies, tons of loot explosions. You have a ton of items that are synergizing with each other and helping you out to beat a run and do tons of AoE damage. I mean, I can't even begin to describe what the first one is. It's absolute insanity. This one, so far, I've only played one run because I was doing a test run for before the recording. In 5 minutes, I can already tell you it's going to get insane, but I'm not going to say anything else. We're just going to hop on into the single player. There is multiplayer as well this time around for the third person, so it's insane. I only have one class unlocked right now. Again, I've only done one run with the commando. I'm pretty sure that they're bringing back a lot. Like, this looks like the Huntress, maybe the Bounty Hunter. It's just going to be awesome. So I'm going to play it on easy right now. And even though you might think, like, oh, why don't you go check your beta card over here, it's going to get insane. So the commando starts off with double tap. This is the one that everyone starts with. Double tap, phase round, tactical dive, and suppressive fire. You're going to need to know all of these because, you'll see. All right, we're on the Titanic Plains, ground zero. And immediately you can tell that, yes, this is obviously not Risk of Rain 1. Now, I was skeptical when I first saw... I only saw this game for a moment on Twitter and on Steam today, or on Twitch today. I was watching Admiral Baru play it a little bit, and I was like, they made a Risk of Rain 2? Why was I not informed, and where can I get this? And I was skeptical, but after playing it, I can tell you already that this game is going to be nuts. It's going to be big. So we have one item here. I'm not exactly sure how to get it. It also might be bugged. Again, I should also mention really quickly that the game is in early access, so expect to see some bugs, graphical glitches, that sort of thing. I've only experienced literally four minutes, 48 seconds of this game. And from the little that I saw, I did get to the first teleporter, and then I got absolutely hosed. Yeah, this is $35. So occasionally you'll come across these items in there. There is a currency system in Risk of Rain 1 where you would walk around, you would find random shops and stores and stuff, or chests that can be unlocked by either paying money so you can open them, or you can donate towards like a statue or something. You can sacrifice stuff to also get them. Our HP is located down in the bottom left-hand corner. Let's go ahead and get this. So repair the gunner turret. We now have a gunner turret, which I don't know if it's going to follow us or if it's just going to protect us. Looks like it just stays there for now, which means that makes me think that the teleporter is somewhere nearby. So this is the regular attack, the right click attack here for the commando just does that little straight sniper shot. Shift is just the tactical roll or dodge. You can sprint if you don't have to hold it. You can just toggle it. And you might be noticing that already we're starting to get a little bit more of a stream of enemies here. And this is where the rain part comes from. I'm not exactly sure what that item means or what that icon means. So this is one of those. We can pay $25 and we can get a mystery item. We can get whatever that is. We can get whatever that is. We have $35 right now. Our money total is located up in the top left-hand corner. And we also have an ultimate as well. Like that. There we go. We got a little stun there. Yeah. But there's never downtime in Risk of Rain because remember, enemies can spawn on you just kind of like this robot right here. And as soon as I saw these guys, it really started to click with me, thinking like, oh yeah, this is going to be insane. Let's take the mystery item. You know, why not? Let's live a little. I don't know what this does, but a personal shield generator. You gain a recharging shield. There we go. So everything in the game. Oh, there's probably we actually probably have money over here from that gunner turret. You can use in the first one. You can have like turrets and stuff that would follow you around or drones, and they would actually automatically shoot and target stuff for you. And they're basically like your cash flow. Money is very important in Risk of Rain, and you get a lot of it by killing stuff, but you can also die very quickly. The idea of Risk of Rain is that you want to try to get as many items as possible to overwhelm your opponents before they can overwhelm you, because you're only one player. It's one player. I don't know what that. I think that was an AOE death rattle. It's you're one player versus a swarm of enemies. You can counteract that swarm by getting a swarm of passive items and active abilities that will allow you to overtake them. But eventually the game will overrun you. Oh my god. So can we go? Can we actually go down there? I'm gonna assume that we probably can. I just gotta find it. I have no idea how big the world is. In the top right-hand corner, you can see how long you're going for. And yes, that does matter as well. One of the things that Risk of Rain is notorious for. Oh, we got a healing drone. A healing drone. Yo, that is awesome. So I paid $40 to get a healing drone. This healing drone will basically, I think, revolve around me and heal me for the rest of the run, I think. Again, you're going to hear a lot of, I don't know what this is. What is that? Oh my god. What is that? The first boss that I saw, I'm not going to spoil it, but she was quite large. What is this? Bustling fungus. Heal all nearby allies after staying still for 2 seconds. Okay, so that's just the way that it worked in Risk of Rain 1. There was a mushroom. I forget the actual name of it, but the mushroom would spout. Now, or would spawn as long as you're standing still. Now, this is the teleporter here, and once I click on this teleporter, it's going to activate a boss. And I don't know if it's anything like the first one. It's probably going to be a random boss. It may be the same one. I'm not sure, but we'll find out in a moment. But right now, we need to get some more items. All right, got a little bit of money there. Let's go see what's in this chest. We got spawned on. Brought a stun there. My ultimate does stun them. Swinging a whiff on that. What's in the chest? Okay, careful now. What is that? Lensmaker glasses. Chance to critically strike, dealing double damage. Okay, so the glass, yeah, those work exactly the same way. I think that was a crit, that those little ting-tings that you heard right there. But it's starting to get, it's a light drizzle. Where's my healing drone's still here. I really wish that there was a gun turret over on this side. So, if this is the first time you're seeing a Risk of Rain game, period, you may notice that things are starting to get a little bit hectic. A lot of money there. You do pick up money automatically. Again, another phrase you're going to be hearing me say is, if it's anything like the first game. And in many ways, there's not a lot. A lot of the stuff is completely different. You have to remember that the first Risk of Rain was a side-scroller 2D action platformer roguelite. It wasn't really less of a platformer. Ooh, there's a market over here. Let's go get... We got to get the mystery item. I mean, we could get some more shades. These will stack if it's anything like the first one and give us a additional crit. But, I mean, come on. We got to take the mystery item. What is that? Stun grenade. Chance to stun on hit. There we go. We stunned that one. I heard that crit as well. Now, if I recall from the first one, you normally want to sit and farm a little bit. Because it's only going to get harder in the later stages. And again, this game is multiplayer. Much like I believe the first one was as well, but... Having a full squad running around in Risk of Rain, especially if the game is going to amp up like the amount of spawn rate and stuff, that's exciting and also insane. You can't jump with spacebar, by the way, which is also very nice. But again, I wasn't expecting this game. I don't think anyone was. Is that my turret? My turret's still going off over there. All right, let's fight the boss here, and I'll just show you what I'm talking about. Who we got? Who's our boss? Wandering Vagrant. Okay, it's one of them. Oh my god. All right, we can shoot those projectiles like the first one. Good. No problem. No, I mean, this is no problem. This is easy. Come at me, Risk of Rain. What you got? There's a board, there is a barrier here that prevents you from escaping. So. I'm just going to be circle stratting my way here. In the first game, I believe that you used to get a bonus if you killed the boss before the teleporter charged. We're doing decent damage right now, but we have incoming from everywhere. We got bogeys on our everything right now. I am playing mouse and keyboard, by the way. I think that's probably the best way to play. I don't know if it's controller compatible. I'm not sure. Oh my goodness. The lighting effects are really, really awesome in the game as well. I like the cell shading. It's got sort of a Wind Waker-esque approach to it. But also maintaining the Risk of Rain look as well. Dude, this is so much stuff. All right, so we downed the boss before the teleporter activated. It's active now. It also drops something, I believe. I'm just going to try to clear out the wave here. Take down the evil wisps up top here. Yeah. All right. So that's my first ever boss kill in Risk of Rain, too. All right. Our build's pretty good. What is this? Red Whip. Move fast out of combat. Interesting. And then we've already healed back to full here. So, yeah. Enter teleporter. Complete a teleporter event. Advancement. Look at that. Wetland Aspect, Rehabilitation Zone. Okay. Let's see here, we don't retain any of our money, which, again, much like the first one, you want to try to farm as much as you can early on. But as you also do see here, we did retain our healing drone. Can we don't... I think there's fall damage. I'm not 100% certain on that, but it looked like there's fall damage. Okay, this is a... What is this? Oh, it's a chest. And again, the deal going on Steam right now is that if you buy a copy before March 30th of this year, of 2019, depending on whenever you're watching this video, you can get a free copy as well to give to one of your friends to play, so you can squad up. Right, we have 45 bucks. Let's go see what's in there. What is it going to be? We've got ourselves, what is that? Sticky bomb. Chance to attach, a chance on hit to attach a bomb to enemies. Let's freaking go. Whoa! He's throwing big old, like, spiky maces at us. There's the sticky bomb. It actually fell off of that. Oh, look, there we go. So you can see here, much like in a... I'm going to equate a lot of it to Isaac because of the way that the item synergies work. The idea is to make yourself powerful and get a bunch of passive items that can help you do what you do best, which is kill, kill, kill. And a lot of the things that you get are going to be passive. Which means that you can continue to play and just farm and kill things and let the rest of your items work for you, essentially, to do the heavy lifting. And so we're still on easy, but we're about to get to medium pretty soon. If you, again, look in the top right-hand corner, you can see that it's consistently ticking up. Again, I'm going for mystery item here. Headkit. Received a delay heal after taking damage. And you can get, by the way, you can get multiple copies of the same trinkets. And they will stack on top of each other, which is another big appeal of Risk of Rain 1. And you can get some crazy builds out there where you had a ton of really, really good items and stuff that all stack. Like, there's one, I forget the name of it, but there's one that you can get that has a force field around you that deals constant damage. As long as anything that's inside of that barrier is your opponent, they will get hit with a ton of damage. My best run ever in Risk of Rain 1 was one where I had a bunch of drones that I had found and repaired across the world, and then I had like a literal drone squad. They're all following me. The thing is, though, in Risk of Rain 1, the drones were indeed targetable by the enemies and killable. So you had to sort of protect them in a weird way. Let's go up here. Anything up here? This is like we're like in a giant mushroom forest. Ooh, look at this. There's a chest over here. What is this? It's a large chest. Oh my. Head, increase jump height, hold jump to slam down on the ground. What? Hold jump to slam down on the ground. Oh, you just hold the space bar, okay. But we don't have time to enjoy this right now. Definitely gonna be doing a little bit more farming than we did in the last set level, because we are gonna start getting an increased amount of HP or increased amount of money here. What's that? Gotta take that. What is it? Oh, it's another shield generator. Okay, so we have two shield generators now. You can see which relics that we have, or trinkets, whatever you want to call them, on the I think they're actually called artifacts. On the top bar there, it shows you exactly what you have. We jump really high now. And it's starting to get a little bit crazy. All right. You guys need to settle down over here. Yeah, you can have a sticky bomb there. You can have, how about you get yourself a dang old sticky bomb? What's this? That's my healing drone. There we go. There you take a little bit of an ultimate. Yeah. Healing drone trying to keep us safe. I appreciate that healing drone making the big time plays. There we go. We got the stun proc. Look at that. We're fine. No problem. There we go. Combat, of course, feels very, very tight. Again, it's mouse. You're aiming with the mouse, so it's pixel perfect as far as your aim is concerned. Got some money there, and we got ourselves a chest. What's in the chest? And it's more crit. Hey, I'll take it. There we go. Yeah, there's another mart over here. Not entirely sure what that icon above the enemies means. Might mean they're elite. I'm not sure. Whoa! Okay, we got blown off the side here. Hey, you need to stop that. Oh! I did the jump. It was like a Goomba stomp. That was awesome. Okay, where's the mart? It was over here, wasn't it? There it is. What is that? That looks... Oh, it's a war banner. Yeah! Drop a war banner on leveling up, giving you strength. Oh, yeah. That's another thing. You do... There are levels in the game. What is this? Oh, this is a sacrifice altar. There are levels in the game. As you see here, we just leveled up, and this is our war banner, which gives us a passive buff as long as we're staying within it. The XP... The XP you can find down in the bottom left, right above my HP. We're currently level 8. Offer the Shrine of Blood. This is going to cost us 50% of our HP. I ain't scared. We can heal up. You feel a searing pain, you gain 85 gold. Cool. It's kind of like a devil deal in a way. Didn't hurt. We've got a couple really good regens. Oh, we can actually sacrifice even more. Gain 127 gold. Yeah, so you see our passive regeneration there is actually kicking in and working real well. All right. Where's our next challenge here? Getting a little bit of a reprieve, although we are now in medium difficulty, which kind of concerns me a little bit. Chest down here, definitely want to go check that out. I appreciate that they actually do give you like a true sprint. What is this? Monster Tooth. Drop a healing orb on kill. Ow. This. Oh, another healing drone. We have two healing drones now. You see there, one of my healing drones did get damaged, though. So we want to keep them around and save as much as we can. See another mart over here. Okay, chest. Okay, there's the teleporter. Okay, we've already been over here. All right, let's go do the teleporter here. I think we're strong enough, and I want to do it before we get to hard difficulty. Wow, those things have some... They've got some weight behind them. Okay, let's find out what the next boss is going to be. Stone Titan. Oh, okay. All right, all right, all right. We got this. That's a big laser beam. And that is a constant laser beam. I should probably try to stun him out of that. The ground is rumbling. Palms are sweaty. He is not stunnable, but he's also not attacking us. He can't keep up with our speed. Teleport is at 40%. Yeah, don't get hit by that. Don't get hit by that. Gotta clear a couple of these adds here. All right, we almost got him down here. Yeah, our damage is actually looking really good. Nice, down he goes, no problem. Sticky bombs doing their work, 68%. Now the monsters will see, they will keep coming for you until the teleporter is active. Crit's doing a lot of work here. Healing drones keep me alive. If I needed to have a reprieve, I could step off and try to find a place I could rest so the mushroom can kick in. And remember, we started on the easiest difficulty, by the way. Oh, portal's up. What is this? Leeching seeds dealing damage here heals you. Do we go through the portal or do we go on the teleporter? What does this mean? We can go to the teleporter or we can go through the blue portal. Let's go through the blue portal. Let's go. No. Let's go. I'm going in. It's not letting me in. Oh, there we go. Bazaar Between Time, Hidden Realm. What is this? Oh, that's cool. If you look at the ground actually has texture to it too. Like it sort of shines and shimmers. It shimmins. Well, we lost all of our gold. Doesn't appear that you can shoot anything in here yet. Maybe this is a hidden. I thought about maybe hidden. I mean, it said bazaar, so what in the world? Two lunar or lunars. Oh, we can trade five items. We can trade three items to reforge to that. Okay, this is sort of like a black market, I'm guessing. Hello, friend. Hello. 10 lunar to free him, it looks like. I don't really want to give up anything, but I kind of want to figure this out. I'm guessing that he can be a companion. Yeah, we can damage him, but he won't retaliate. Ooh, do we give up three items? Sure, why not? We got Will-O-Wisp. Didn't enemies on kill. Okay, so we lost... What did we lose? We lost War Banner, Leech Seed, and something else. No, we still have Leech Seed. We lost three things. I don't know where you get Lunar from, but... Again, I'm gonna suspect that this is probably... Maybe a random occurrence? Oh, and we're in the next area. Okay. So we don't get to go back to that other area. That's good to know. But make sure that you have everything before you enter into the extra portal. Got a nice little snow area here. Not sure what this... This is like a shrine. Pray to the Shrine of Combat. Summon Greater Wisp to fight. Now, as you can see, we're dealing significantly less damage to these mobs in this level. And remember that the timer is still ticking. I've lived for 22 minutes. It's not bad. This is only my second run. But already, I will say that if you love the first Risk of Rain, this is probably an automatic pickup for you. I'm sure that when people probably first saw this game earlier today, they were pretty skeptical. I mean, I was too. I was like, how in the world could they make Risk of Rain into a third-person shooter? But then I played it. And it's like, oh, this is how. They just simply did it. They just simply made the first one, but you're now much closer to combat. And it's open world-ish. Co-op online with quick play and everything. That is awesome. They also have a daily challenge. What is that? Hey, you need to cool your jets there, Bison. Buffalo, I see too many of you. Zoom in, Wagon Adventure. Oh, God, the teleporting demons. Okay, we need to find chests. We haven't found a single one yet. Oh, I hate that. I don't like that. Those explosions that you're seeing, those are from Will-O-The-Wisp. The music, of course, excellent as always. I assume it's made by the same... The music was done by the same composer from the first one. Sounds very similar. Okay. All right. Where's our chests at? Where are all my chests at? I see a market. Okay, I see two marts over here. Wow, these things just don't give up. They also take a lot of damage. There we go. A sword. I gotta take the sword. I don't even know what it does. All right. Oh no, it's a syringe. Increase attack speed. And we've unlocked the cane or crowbar or something. Didn't hurt. There we go. I'm trying not to lollygag here. I just don't trust these buffalo things. There we go. I don't know if blowing these things up does anything. Doesn't seem like it. All right, let's keep moving over here. And to anyone wondering, no, you can never truly destroy everything in the game. The game will constantly be sending stuff at you. Case in point. Oh, there's another mark over here. Oh, there's three of them now. Okay. We gotta move, gotta move, gotta move. Gotta go fast. We gotta go fast. There's a chest here. Oh, it's foreign fruit. Heal on use. Use 3D printer. The game he busted. Oh, these just print. It takes one item and converts to another. What? So you can take random items to get the ones that you want. Getting slightly crazy here. I'll take that one. All right. Get gasoline. Killing enemies sets nearby enemies on fire. That's what I like to see. All right. We're doing okay. This is fine. Yep. The healing drones are still with me. I got my drone squad over here. All right. You can't touch this, team. Oh my god. Oh, we got another Will-O-The-Wisp. So that 3D printer, whoa! That 3D printer thing, you can essentially build the item that you want if it's an item that you want. So if I wanted to stack that the toadstool buff or the mushroom buff, I could. Whenever we're out of combat, we heal for more. Oh my god, these bison things. Again, the art style really, really, really looks sharp in 3D. That chain reaction of the explosions on the Will-O-The-Wisp, that's the level that you want to get your damage to, where when you kill things, they also kill things around the thing that you killed. I know there's something in there because I saw it, but I want to see what's up here first. as a fire elite or something. Not bad. We need more damage. Level, are we level 11 right now? Okay, let's go. Let's go jump on top of here and see what we got. Whoa! Didn't hurt. I cannot jump. I cannot jump up there. We still don't know where the teleport is. We're on hard difficulty, by the way. What is this? Oh, you know what? This is a speed... That's probably like a speed chest. Yeah, we were 10 minutes behind where we needed to be there. Yeah. Sorry, this isn't going to be a speed run. This is also going to be a little bit longer of a video than I thought, but I'm not going to leave you halfway through this run. There's a chest here. Drop healing orb on kill. Awesome. The healing orbs also, they get, they will also, I think, auto-gravitate towards you. Maybe. No, they won't. Oh, we were kind of full HP there. It didn't matter. Where's the teleporter, though? It's only going to get rougher from here. The teleport in the last level was pretty well hidden. I didn't actually mean to jump off of there. Can I jump back up? Try to sprint and jump. Nope. There is something up there, though. Save me, healing drone. Like a pod up here. Not open. Oh god. Yeah, let's not get hit by that. Lone survivor, stay alive for 30 consecutive minutes. Hey, look at that. No problem. Give me a real challenge game, even though I'm still playing on the easy difficulty. And it has been challenging. I think we have a pretty decent survivability builder here right now. We've already been over here. Oh, we've already been over here. Where's the daggum teleporter? If I don't see it, they can't see me. I'm just gonna ignore whatever's behind us. If I can't see you, you don't exist. Oh, we're actually moving pretty fast. Hard light afterburner. Add 2 extra charges of your utility skill. Reduce the. Oh, that's the combat roll. Got another sticky bomb. Awesome. What is this? All it's doing is spawning stuff. It may be a monster spawner, but yeah, look at that. Look at the chain reactions that we're getting now from Will-O-The-Wisp. And they're just, and it's straight up just combusting and destroying anything that's around our target when it dies. All right, we found the teleporter. Let's hit it. What we got? Imp Overlord. Where is... Oh. Oh! Oh my god. And he teleports. This is fine. No problem. No problem. Trying to take out the ads, get some healing orbs going. There we go. Alright. Alright. This is good. He's got a lot of HP. Music sounding pretty metal. Oh my god, what was that? Yeah, let's not get hit by that attack, whatever it is. We stopped the ads for now. I imagine he'd be a lot easier if we had gotten here like a while ago. Oh no, a healing drone. Can't lose the healing drone. All right, we just leveled up. Teleport's at 99%. Too quick for him. Get me out of here. There we go. Need some good old-fashioned bison burgers. We did lose one healing drone. Rose Buckler, reduce incoming damage while sprinting. Nice. Warrior, reach the complete third teleporter without dying. Not too bad, although I'm not going to feel good about it because, again, we are kind of on... We are on the easiest difficulty. Abyssal Depths. Are you just gonna start right in my face, huh? This place looks very ominous. What is that? Is this decoration or is this a thing? I think it's just decoration. What in the world is that? Oh my god. Like it's a flame salamander. All right, it's getting a little difficult to kill things. Gonna go ahead and combat roll out here. All right, don't worry, don't mind me. I'm just rolling in the air. It's space. Come on. These things are not dying. You do gain stat ups whenever you level, by the way. I sort of wish that the dive... I wish that the utility move was bound to the right mouse button instead of the instead of shift. It's a little bit awkward trying to dodge with shift. Oh, that's 2,000. I thought it was 219. We're gonna have some problems here, team. If these are the regular mobs that they're taking forever to kill, I do not want to know what the bosses are going to do. What is this? I think that's a grenade. Sure. We gave up sticky bombs and we get sun grenade. Yep. We have double jump now. The hop of feather. Yeah, now the order that you do maps. So look at all the stuff that we have around us. Oh, you know what? Those are all of our artifacts that we have attached to us. I didn't even notice that until now. So like you can see the multiple mushrooms, you can see the sticky bombs. That's really cool. To give you a visual representation on your character whenever you pick up a new item. That's pretty neat. Very much, very, very much like Isaac in that regards. What is this? We have ourselves a giant door. A door that I cannot go into yet. Truth be told, we're not making that much money right now either. That thing's too strong. I do sort of wish that there was a map as well. Maybe that's something that we can get later on. Hey, stop attacking my healing drone. Or maybe they're planning on introducing one in the early access period later on. Again, the game is in early access, so everything you see here may not accurately represent the game upon full release. I don't know, where do I even get out of here? Will of the Wisp doing pretty good. Gotta jump out of here. There's a sticky bomb. Got the sticky bomb right on his face. Dude, this guy is just not... Oh, he's just gonna peace out, huh? Can't peace out on me. Where do you think you're going? He's trying to regenerate his shield. Got the stun, sticky bomb. There we go. Things are firing mortars at us or something. Well, we found the teleporter against my better judgment because I don't know how much longer this run's gonna go for. Let's just see what the boss is like. I'm not expecting to beat it. And things are getting crazy. You know what? Why not? What's the worst that could happen? Oh god, it's the magma worm. What is this gonna look like? Oh, that's... Yep, that's what I was expecting. Okay. Alright. Alright. This is all good. Completely fine. No problem. We got the DPS to handle it. No problem. It just looks like a nightmare. I'm gonna have to use our fruit. I used our fruit. Just don't get hit by that or that. Alright. Alright. Gotta make the big time plays. I haven't even tried to shoot the magma worm yet. There he is. All right. I didn't make it. Woo, 40 minutes. 40 minutes of that. Good Lord. Man, anyway, I'm gonna wrap it up there. Thank you everybody for watching this first impressions. A little bit longer than I thought it would be, but man. Yeah, if you had any concern about Risk of Rain 2 not being anything like Risk of Rain 1, no longer that. When we just unlocked the Huntress as well, a new class. Oh, not new class, because she was in the first one, but new class in Risk of Rain 2. So anyway, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Again, if you're interested in picking up this game, you can do so right now and get an extra bonus copy by going to Steam. This game is in early access. I don't normally put out early access trailer footage, or not trailer footage, but videos anymore. But with Risk of Rain 2, I just could not help myself. So let me know in the comments down below how you thought about it, if you're playing it, what your favorite class is so far. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!